those tears you shed, I call them your amber moment. And trust me, if you have not shed a tear in this struggle 1 year down the line, then you are not supposed to be there. I can bet that all of us sitting here have had our amber moment. The most remarkable for me was on the 22nd of September, while we were going to New York from Baltimore here. I was privileged to be in the same car with Justice Ebon and Governor Ayuk, and to me, these are the true heroes of this talk. Just with a big hand. How much can we do when you look at people like Mulanjoli Tabe? Our struggle, you see, we are the blessed generation. We are here standing on the shoulders of the giants who made it possible. So when I'm in the company of all these people, it humbles you. And I don't know how to say thank you to them. Being a person like my brother, big brother, Christmas Eve, how much would I say thank you to him for what he's done? We happen to be the lucky generation because, look at everybody says Sisiku, Sisiku. And that's because they have made pathway for us. And so it always touches my heart. Yesterday I was with Ambassador Possum. When you meet these people, you look at people who have abandoned it all to be here. Governor Ayuk, on our way to New York that day, I think he lost it. At some moment, that amber moment came. And he cried like a baby inside that car. You know why he was crying? He said, I never knew this day would come. But Governor, I'm thankful to be part of your service. We have come a long way in 2017. Don't let anybody fool you.
Yes.
We've come a very long way. However, we still have a long way to go. I'm going to try it so that I don't give away. I'm sure you know we are expecting a big speech tomorrow. And so I'm going to hold myself because if I... The way I'm going now, I start giving away things, and that's not very good. That's not very good. We have been told that tomorrow, at about the same time that the president of our neighboring council will be speaking, our own president will be speaking. We are challenging them. And we are asking CRTV to watch, to check their indicators, how many people in Ambazonia will tune to CRTV. The moment has come when they must know where the authority of Ambazonia comes from. We might be thousands of kilometers away, but God knows it's only a matter of when. We will be in Boya to finalize this restoration struggle. Yes. Our speech will be delivered at that same time. And when we finish it, we will do a pigeon version of that speech. Yes. We have to talk to our people. And when we finish talking in pigeon, we give them a sense of what we have just said. We say it in French for them to know that we know what we are doing. By the way, you guys have to watch out. Trust me, when you see your president tomorrow, you'll be proud of his attire. We are going to do things very differently.
Yes!
Because we are going to build a different nation.
Of course.
I challenge myself and I challenge my government. Because 5 years, after we settled in Boya, anybody who crosses the moon will say, my God, my God, look at what he has transformed this day. I said this to public, and I know that we're in the first century, so it's recorded, because I want that tomorrow, even if, God forbid, we try to fail, people will call us and say, you said it, now you're going to change it.
that if anybody climbs up and bows, by the time they get to Sankara, they will stand and say, what has the Lord built? We are going to do a very different mission. As my friends have been telling you, we are already into very interesting discussions. We are into very extensive discussions.
Those tears you shed, I call them your amber moments. And trust me, if you have not shed a tear in this trouble 1 year down the line, then you are not supposed to be. I can bet that all of us sitting here have had our amber moments. The most remarkable for me was from the 22nd of September, while we were going to New York from Baltimore here. I was privileged to be in the same car with Justice Ebong and Governor Ayuk. And to me, these are the true heroes of this struggle. Just with a big hand. How much can we do when you look at people like Mulan Jolly today?
Our struggle, you see, we are the blessed generation. We are here standing on the shoulders of the giants who made it possible. So when I'm in the company of all these people, it humbles you. And I don't know how to say thank you to them. Being a person like my brother, big brother, Christmas Eve, how much would I say thank you to him for what he's done? We happen to be the lucky generation because, look at everybody sees Sisiku, Sisiku, and that's because they have made pathway for us. And so it always touches my heart. Yesterday I was with Ambassador Fosso. When you meet these people, you look at people who have abandoned it all to be here. Governor Acho, on our way to New York that day, I think he lost it. At some moment, that amber moment came. And he cried like a baby inside that car. You know why he was crying? He said, I never knew this day would come.
Oh. Ambassador Governor, I'm thankful to be part of your service. We have come a long way in 2017. Don't let anybody fool you.
Yes.
We've come a very long way. However, we still have a long way to go. I'm going to try so that I don't give away. I'm sure you know we are expecting a big speech tomorrow. And so I'm going to hold myself because if I, the way I'm going now, I start giving away things, and that's not very good. That's not very good. We have been told that tomorrow, at about the same time that the president of our neighboring council will be speaking, our own president will be speaking. We are challenging them.
Yes.
And we are asking CRTV to watch.
Correct.
To check their indicators. How many people in Ambazonia would tune to CRTV? The moment has come when they must know where the authority of Ambazonia comes from. We might be thousands of kilometers away. God knows it's only a matter of when we will be in Boya to finalize this restoration struggle.
Yes.
Our speech will be delivered at that same time. And when we finish it, we will do a pigeon version of that speech.
Yes.
We have to talk to our people. And when we finish talking in pigeon, give them a sense of what we are just saying. We say in French for them to know that we know what we are doing. And by the way, you guys have to watch out. Trust me, when you see your president tomorrow, you'll be proud of his account. We are going to do things very differently.
Yes.
Yes.
because we are going to build a different nation.
Of course.
I challenge myself and I challenge my government, because 5 years after we settled in Wales, anybody who crosses the border will say, my God, look at what he has transformed his nation. I say this to public, and I know that we are in the first century, so it's recorded, because I want that tomorrow, even if, God forbid, we try to fail, people will call us and say, you said it and you're going to change it. That if anybody climbs up and bow to, by the time they get to Sankara, they will stand and say, what has the Lord built? We are going to build a very different nation. As my friends have been telling you, we are already into very interesting discussions. We are into very extensive discussions because the world is taking us seriously. The people of the world know that we have only one way. The train has left the station. We would only stop in Wales. Only Mr. Bia is aware. He knows he cannot stop us. I have for my family and I want to thank all of you for accepting me as your leader. And I hope you will do this together. Thank you, and God bless you.
Do we have a great president of us? So he's the Moses that is taking us out of Egypt.